Hi everybody, Pierre from Reception Academy. Today we are going to discuss the correction of the exercise 17 from our home study guide.
Please note this tutorial video has been designed for students taking the Opera PMS home study course. If you don't have already access to the software, you could find more information about the course on our website. I have added the course link to the video description below, and you could get Opera PMS installed and tag along. You just have to click on Book Now.
For this exercise, I have created a reservation under the name of John Doe. It is a booking arriving tonight, for 2 days, and for 2 guests. The guest has no credit card to guarantee the booking, so I set up rest type as 4 p.m. release, by cash, and I had to put the arrival time, which I put at 4 o'clock. Your guest wants the Fashion Doll Quarterly magazine in the room for this term. So here, what you wanted to do is to create a trace. Go to Options, Traces, and because we had to send the concierge to get the magazine, you had to select the concierge code and then type in the message. Please arrange the Fashion Doll Quarterly magazine and click on OK. Then you wanted to press Close on your Traces window, and you wanted to close your options and save. Add guest address details to the booking. So you wanted to go to your profile ellipsis and you wanted to type in the address, ensuring that each word starts with a capital letter. 10 words. Once you are done with your details, you want to click on OK and save. Your guest requested 2 extra bathrobes and 2 extra pairs of slippers in the bedroom. So here what you wanted to do is inform housekeeping. To do so, create a trace. Options. Traces, click on New, select the housekeeping department, and here you wanted to type in the message. Please arrange 2 extra bathrobes and 2 extra pairs of slippers for the guest. Once you're happy with your message, you click on OK, you close your traces window, you close your options window, and you save. Attach the company, I am a Barbie Girl Limited, to the reservation. So to do so, you wanted to go to the company field, just like so, and write down the name of the company and press Tab. The system will divert you to the profile search screen, and here you will see the list of the company under the same name. I do not see any companies matching the address of the academy, so I will create one. To do so, you need to click on Search, and then you will be able to click on New. Search, New. Then you need to write down the minimum details in order for the sales team to get in touch with that company. So, and you also want to add the generic email address and telephone number. Once you're happy with all those details, you just need to click on OK. Once your company has been attached, in case your market was set to leisure, it is important that you update it to corporate. Once everything is done, click on Save. Your guest always wants a room on a high floor with a nice view, such as river view or city view. So in our hotel, we don't have river view, but we've got city view. Go to your drop-down menu, select city view, just like so, and you want it to scroll down and select your high floor request. Once you selected both, click on OK. The system prompts you if you want it attached to the profile. Because you want it always, you need to say yes and save. For the next task, your guest has received 7 parcels. Concierge holds them, please hand them over on arrival. So what you wanted to do is you wanted to create an alert, a reminder for the front desk team that we are having those parcels and they need to be handed over on arrival. To do so, click on Options, select Alerts. You wanted to click on your drop-down menu for the code and select Packages, just here. Area, you wanted to hand them over on arrival, so it was check-in. And here, you wanted to free type your message. Please inform guests that the concierge holds 7 parcels for them. And click on OK. Press Close on your address window. And close your options. Then save. Send email confirmation to the guest. To do so, you wanted to click on Options. You wanted to go to your confirmation, just like so, and you wanted to select email the cross just in the box, and then you wanted to click on send. If you've done it right, the system will show you that the email is succeeded, and then you can press close. Close your options and save. Prior to checking the guests, because the room is specific and arriving today, I would assign a room in advance and write in the comments, do not move, and the reason why. So let's select a room together. There is no room with a city view in my hotel, so I'll just remove that code. High floor is more important. Search, and then I select 77. I go to my comments, and I write down the letter do not move, and the reason why. Magazine, and housekeeping setup. Once you're happy with those details, you just press save. For the next task, I need to check in the guest. Because your guest doesn't have a credit card, we will have to obtain a cash deposit. The deposit should cover for the cost of the stay, plus an extra £50 per night. So, £270 times 2 is £540, and £50 per night for the extras is an extra £100. So we take a £640 cash payment upon arrival. What I will do now is I will accelerate the check-in process, and once I open cashiering billing, I will show you how to take the cash payment for the deposit. Okay, we are now on the bill. As you can see, I checked in my guest. Now I will take the cash deposit. So I click on payment. I will collect from the guest £640, and I will post them. So I click on post. The last thing I need to do is I will have to go to the no post tool and remove it because the guest gave me money to cover for the extras. And now your guest is checked in. So now let's do the posting. I click on post. So my guest had a dinner, so let's write restaurant dinner food for £30. And then it was restaurant dinner beverage for £22. Your guest has a reception to pay for taxi on arrival from City Airport. So that was a paid out, £25. And in reference, you write down car transfer from City Airport. Press enter. In a real life, you need to print a copy because you will have removed some money from your float. In my case, I press close. Then my guest had a breakfast in the morning. So once again, restaurant, breakfast food, and that was for £20. And my guest organized the Fashion Doll magazine quite early. So this time it was paid out again because we have to go outside and buy it for the guest. And it was £10. And then you write down in the reference Fashion Doll magazine. You press enter. Then like last time, I will press close. Then my guest use internet in room. So I write down internet. That was for £15. And then my guest use a minibar for still water. Say yes to post article. Select still water. Press OK. And my guest accidentally broke a bedside radio. So, it's miscellaneous. £15. And in reference, you write down broken bedside radio. I press enter. Once you're happy with all your posting, you just need to press close. And here you will see that all the items which have been posted to the bill have been added to your window one. I just realized that my guest also asked for tickets for a weekend. So I write paid for paid out. Let's say that it was £80 a ticket. So 80, two tickets. And here you write on the reference theater tickets. And here you can put the show, which was weekend. You could specify two theater tickets. So two theater tickets. Now, once you are happy with those details, you click post. Say close. And close your posting window. And you will see that your two theater tickets has been added to the bill. For the next task, we had to move the guest to a different room, either a higher or lower category, but the guest must be charged for the price of the room they are moved to. So I could do it from that window and go to options and room move, but to make it more clear for you, I will close my bill and I will go to in-house guest. So go to my front desk, in-house guest, it will make it easier, more visual. So then I find my guest though, I find the bouquet, and here I want to click on options, and I want to click on remove. And I will select so different categories. So let's go for a double deluxe, which is the next category higher. Then I remove my features and I click search. My system gives me a selection of room. So let's select 703, which is on the seventh floor. Press OK. Now, for the reason that will be a paid upgrade, and press OK. And click on OK on the room move window. The system will ask you what is the status of the previous room, 707. In a real life hotel, depending how long the guest has been inside, it could be pickup if it was 5 to 10 minutes. If he slept overnight, I would select dirty. In my case, I will select inspected. And the system prompts me the question, informing that I change the room type of my guest from a double to a double deluxe. Do I want to continue? So I say yes. And then the system asks me about the room type charge. Now, room type charge is how much your guest will be charged for. Because we need to charge a guest, we need to say yes to the question. Close your options window. And here, as you can see, my guest room type is double deluxe, and the price he pays for the room is the one of the double deluxe. That's why the room rate has increased from £270 to £290. So now I will go back to my bill. I press OK. Now, one last thing which is important is, in a real life scenario, if you make an upgrade like this and the guest is paying by cash, similar way for a credit card, yeah, you should always ensure that the guest gives you extra money to pay for the upgrade. In our case, it was £20 per night, so you should get a cash deposit of £40 to cover the cost of the extra. In addition to that, your guest went over his credit limit already, so you should ask the extra deposit to cover those extras which are already on the bill. Remember that once we will check out the guest, now it's not anymore 540 which will be added to the bill, but a total of 580. And you have only £341 left of credits. For the next task, your guest wanted all the food items and the room rate on a separate invoice under the company name. So to do so, you wanted to do routing. Click on options, select routing. At the top of the form, click on window. Because you have attached your company name, click on the drop-down menu. Select the company name. Press OK. Press close on your routing instructions. Say no to refresh folio. Close your options. Perform a right click and select new window. As you can see, the window 2 is renamed under I am a Barbie Girl LTD, and you just have to drag and drop the charges. So, the restaurant dinner food, the breakfast food, and we need to pause room rate. So for that, we needed to change the system to 0 night. I will do an early departure. That will be faster. So I click on settlement, I select early departure, and I press OK. The system prompts me that the charge has been posted. I press OK. And then I close my payment window. And I will drag and drop my accommodation, which is my room rate, to my window 2. And that's it. We've got the accommodation and the food items on the window 2. This brings the correction of our exercise 17 to an end. Thank you for watching and see you in our next video.